Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Korlak, and welcome to another Gmod add-on review video. Today I'm going over JI Defense Solutions. And most people here probably don't know this add-on, because not many people use it unless it's on a Base Wars or... Base Wars or just... or sandbox or something. So, what JI Defense Solutions is basically you can pretty much build an entire base out of all this stuff that is out of this. And also has armor and gear, which is awesome. I'll go through all of this actually. This is gonna be a long video. This might be at least a 30 minute video just to give you guys a heads up because of all this stuff. Holy crap. Alright, well first let's go over the armor panels. Here you go. Here's your armor panels where this is where you're going to be having your base. You're basically your base walls or reinforcing your walls. Now, nothing can get through this. I don't even think antimatter material can get through that. So hold on, let me find some FAS weapons. And let me look for a really, really good weapon. Okay. Now I want to. Okay, I'm gonna put a target at the back of this. Let me put an NPC. What NPC do I want? Just Half-Life Resistance. Oh no, that's the wrong one. A citizen. All right. Now I don't know if I have this set up right, so I'm just gonna. Oh, gave me a hit marker. I didn't tell you to come over here.
Yeah, pardon me.
Stay over there. Stay. Hold on. Give me, NPCs. Disable thinking. Stay. Maybe a little farther out. Oh. Alright. Now let me add another NPC here and see if I have it the right way here. Oh! Oh yeah, that's another thing. Bullet deflection is on this. So... nothing can get through this. Yeah, and it also kills you if you're too close. So, yeah, that's the armor panels. Basically, you can, if I go back to entities, you can basically build armored structures to keep your base safe, or like little tiny panels for like tiny forts. These are the three different sizes of armor panels. Like, okay, the way I have them facing this way, you can shoot through. The other way are bulletproof. So if I shoot anything on this side, so let me get the, so I can show you. See, they look completely different. They look completely the same on each side. So, basically, to test out which is the right side, is shoot it and see if you take damage. Or if someone's taking damage from the other side. That's how you find out these. Alright. Now, yeah, I got through the stupid panels that kill people, that like to kill people. Let's go over the turrets. And there's a bunch of them. This is an anti-material turret. Anti-material turret. So, to see to see what ammo it requires is, it says it on its side, so this takes 0.338 Lupa Magnum Anti-Material Sniper. So, 0.338 ammo box, you click E on the turret and click on the ammunition button, and it instantly sinks. Same thing with a battery. Let's see, this thing requires electricity. Electricity does, see, you have your percentage bar over here, or percentage counter. This will let people know, or this will tell you when you have, like, well, how much power you got left. So if I hit the electricity, it will sink. And then I hit activate, and then the turret is activated, and it will shoot anything that it sees. So let me hit it and hit illuminate and warn, and then exit. So now, if it sees something that it doesn't like, it will start to warn. Why is it not shoot? Oh, that's right. It counts as an NPC. So, does it? Did I sink an IFF? Is it synthetics and organics? Oh, okay, yeah, there's also class sizes. Let me enable all those. Oh, shit.
Access denied.
What? Oh, that's new.
Access denied.
Oh, so when it's activated, when it's armed, you can't, yeah, when it's armed, you can't... You can't access it. Now if you don't want it to shoot you or your teammates, if you have an IFF tag, which is this little thing right here, if you have an IFF tag and click E and sync IFF with it, you will pretty much be able to, you know, it won't shoot you. See? Wait. Yep, it's targeting me. This thing is damn accurate too if you're moving. That actually made me jump too. Eh, god. Okay, now I'm gonna spawn up. I'm getting out of the way of that thing. Oh my god, I thought it was gonna turn all the way. Tank. See, it only takes one shot at a time for the anti-material. Now, the thing is, with the anti-material, with the turrets, they do take damage. They're not indestructible. But the thing is, if you want to instantly repair your turret without spawning a new one, or buying a new one if you're in a server, is that you find a turret repair kit, which is right here. You take it right, you just basically put it right next to the turret and click E on the box. Or, supposed to. Oh. Maybe I'm having it the wrong direction. There we go. It wasn't damaged all the way. Okay, now, see, it's fully repaired, but the thing is that you have no more power. So every time your turret is destroyed, you always have to basically put another battery. So to replace batteries, just click electricity. It takes out the old battery, and click electricity again, and there you go. And then hit activate again, and there you go. You have another working turret. Don't worry about the ammo canister, that stays. You don't have to replace that. Only when the ammo is, like, empty, and it will let you know when the ammo is empty because the turret will start clicking. So let me oops. Hold up, I messed up. Alright. Now, let me spawn a machine gun turret. Do the same thing. Battery. Now, what ammo does this take? 7.62? Activate. And now, this thing will shoot for a while. And they're really strong. Oh, actually, this is a perfect... Oh, I forgot to, forgot to click E on my spawn. Alright, now, this is a perfect time for the armor test. Okay. Now, which armor is good for this ballistic nylon? And the thing is, it does change your HUD. So, let me go to weapons real quick and go to... Go to here. So it does actually change your player model and add the armor and everything. So ow! God, you do a lot of damage. Ow! That hurt. Now I forgot how to take off the armor. I think if you just click entities. I think if you click another like another piece of armor, it does take it off. No, it doesn't. I guess you just kill yourself. Alright. I'm trying to think on what helmet? Fine, I'll just go with this one. And I think this one, this vest actually can take more hits. Never mind, it cannot take more hits. And let me just grab that. Never mind. It can't take any more hits. Alright, now... The ballistic shield... The thing about the ballistic shield is, yes, it works, but you cannot equip it. I mean, you can pick it up, like, hold it with E. And see, it won't target you if you're in front of it, because you're being covered by the ballistic shield. But if you, yeah, if you lift up or go up or down in any way, it will instantly kill you. Stop. I think it's enough for that turret. I'll go with some vehicles real quick. Okay. Where is my WAC aircraft? There they are. I'll spawn a jet, and I'll spawn a missile turret. Now, these missile turrets are really accurate as hell. So, but I'll just say this: the most you need for a missile turret is probably just one. Thing is, though, with this add-on, I'll give everyone a warning that you only need The only thing you need is just one turret. The, I'll say this though, you cannot spawn at least, I think the max you can spawn before your server starts lagging or your computer starts lagging, because this takes a lot of, I don't know, it takes a lot, like, it lags your server to hell. So I think the max you can spawn is at least 5 before it starts lagging like crazy. Yep. And that's how accurate the missile turret is. I didn't even hear it fire. I keep moving my spawn point. I hate it when I do that. Alright. Now you got the idea for missiles. Slam mines? Those are pretty much like normal Half-Life mines. The way you equip them to the ground is double click E on the ground. And I just did a Patrick Star. Yeah, and they're motion sensor, just like in the, just like the Half-Life slams. So if I go to like Half-Life weaponry, ooh, I can find Half-Life 2 weapons and find a slam. Basically, they're the same thing. Just, yeah. So, let me get rid of those. A sleeping bag? Okay, this sleeping... Okay, sleeping bag counts as a mobile spawn point like this I have right here. So, if you click E on it, your spawn point has been set. But I like my spawn point. I like these better. Because anyway, these, I think, these can be destroyed. Those cannot. Now you have, let's see, you have naval mines. To activate naval mines, click E. And just drop them in the water if it doesn't explode. They will float. They will just float and stay there. They'll be stationary. So if you guys want to reenact some battles with naval mines and have boats running in, you can. The explosive power of a naval mine is pretty strong. It will definitely get the job done. Now, paints. A paint kit? I have no idea. I have never messed with the paint kit before. So, I don't know what to do with that. You guys can probably find out on your own. I mean, I've only messed with this add-ons only for a little bit. I haven't really fully experienced the entire add-on and see what they can do. I mean, I'm still trying to learn on I'm still learning about the aid communicator and other stuff. So you have all, okay, you also have these other suits. You have let's see, you have a hazmat suit, a fire suit, basically a gas. So, oh, that's not even a suit. It's just a kit. Get that out of there. Let's see. Okay, you have your hazmat suit. So it does change your player model's look. So let me go back to Robot Boy's weapons. Now, see, it basically makes me look like a combine. Just painted yellow. So yeah, combine makes me look like I'm yellow. Also has the hazmat symbol on the gas mask. let's see. Now you have, after your hazmat suit, you have your fire suit. Which, this thing is very, is all fire resistant. It does player model into a combine, but you are all shiny and silvery. So, you're all shiny, so pretty much fire resistant. What the fuck? Why did I spawn all the way over here? I thought I spawned my point. I set my spawn point here. Anyways, okay, let's continue. Let's see. Got a darted hazmat, fire. Okay, your EOD. Your EOD suit is basically a juggernaut. You're basically a juggernaut. And another thing that I've actually learned on doing this, if you go to Half-Life 2 and stuff and just spawn suit battery, basically it has double the energy and double the damage resistant. So thing is about the suit though is you are super slow. You can't sprint with it. So. Like, I'll shoot an RPG at the ground, and if this kills me instantly, I'm gonna be really pissed. Yeah, I only took seven damage, and most of the suit battery is just 73. So you're really strong in this, but you're just super slow. Okay, now time to go with. Okay, I guess that's it for. Oh yeah, and does change your HUD, so your basically your peripheral vision and everything else is going to be obscured. So when you're going to be, if you're going to do this for like attacking or facing your target, basically you're going to be facing your target head on instead of going like attacking tactically. Okay, now time to go with landmines. Ooh, these are fun. So, you have your three different type of landmines. You have your small, medium, and large. Your small... Why did I enable all three? Anyways, small does little damage. Yeah, I'm gonna spawn them like farther out. Let's see. Okay, your small landmine. Got that. Got your medium. And you got your large. Alright. Now, I'm gonna spawn in the EOD suit because I need to be in this thing. If I'm going to show you the amount of damage you take inside it. So, small landmine, take 7 damage. We got Half-Life 2 and heal. Medium should take around 10 to 15 damage. Never mind, 8 damage. A large should do quite a bit. Yeah. Also blasts you up in the air, and once you land it, you take 10 fall damage. So, there's that. Oh, there is another thing I wanted to show. Okay, if you go back to, if you spawn a large landmine, get your duplicator, duplicate it. You can pretty much. You can pretty much spawn kill everyone just with a tool gun, just with your duplicator, and it spawns multiple extra ones. So all of these are super freaking dangerous now. So, it spawns, it explodes, but it leaves the landmine there. That's the weird thing. I don't know. It's so weird. And if you actually got, if you develop a script, like what me and my friends do, me, my friend Johnny, and a couple others, if you guys develop a script with your mouse, and if you just hold down left click, it will actually double, or actually, if I think it's multiple clicks, to be honest, because the tool gun doesn't work if you just hold down left click. If you click multiple times, it doubles it, so you can pretty much be shooting a machine gun while with the duplicator, so it's pretty much 10 times faster than that. Basically 10 times faster than that. So I hope you guys have fun. I hope you guys enjoyed that little cheat. They might want to look into that and fix it, to be honest. Alright, bombs. We're going to go into JI Defense Solution bombs, which is really fun. So, if I hold it above the ground and click E on it, it will start ticking down, and it will explode into these little tiny landmines, or cluster mines. And if you have... Now, I gotta be careful, because if I step on one, I'm dead. So that's why I'm crouching to look where they're at. Now, here's a cool little trick about these things. If you have this lightsaber add-on, and you have... Oh, shit. If you have Force Repulse, not Leap, and just hold it down to full charge it, and release... That might have been really loud on your end. It was really loud on mine. But if you do that, basically you can get rid of all the mines around your area. So, there is that. The aid communicator. Oh wait, I'm not even done with bombs. What am I saying? Okay, claymores. Everyone should know how to work a claymore. Like it said, numpad 0 is default key. And the explosion goes outwards this way. So, let me spawn another. So whenever you... There you go, it's standing up. So, this is the front, and this is where the enemy is going to be. And I am probably going to die instantly. Yeah. You guys can have a lot of fun with that if you're playing around on Base Wars, or just even playing around on Sandbox, and just screw around with your friends. Alright. Bouncing mine, or bouncing, what most people like to call them, bouncing Bettys. They'll spawn, randomly on the side, but once you click E in them, they'll sink into the ground. And they're very hard to target while in a grassy area like this. And if you're just walking and walk over it, it does explosion damage, and then it also does shrapnel damage. So when I ran away from it, from the explosion, the shrapnel took up most half of my health. Let's see, is there any more explosives that I'm missing? Oh yeah, there is one more, which is the most deadly, which I'm gonna spawn over here. The war mine, and basically you can spawn as many of these as you want. Now how the war mine works is basically it works like a turret. If you have IFF tag equipped, you can sync your IFF tag so when you walk near it, it will start illuminating blue. I'll show you guys right here. I have an IFF tag. I'll equip it. Then I'll arm the mine. Now, is it gonna stop? All right. Yeah. See right there. If I move near it, it starts glowing blue and giving a little tick. Like, okay, this guy's a friendly. This thing is all based off of movement. So, like the slightest movement or jump, it will start to detect and blow up. So let me kill myself and then head over to the war mine and like slowly head towards it. See, it's all about movement and it has a really long range. Now, if you move like a lot, like running straight towards it, basically instant explosion. Slightly moving towards it could result if you get close. You could probably get close enough to deactivate it. You gotta be like really slow. I'll show you. Yeah, all detected. It's all movement detection. And it has a massive explosion. That's why it's called the War Mine. Now, there is other stuff you can do. If you're in a RP server, there's also boxes of food where you can eat and basically regenerate health. Same thing with water. Water will do the same thing for regenerating health. But if you like on a survival server with this type of add-on, and this would actually be really good to have. generators and gas. This thing does make noise, so this is probably gonna. I can't remember which gas canister it takes. Okay, it takes diesel. So, what this can do is it can recharge turrets and recharge aid communicators. Let me turn it off. The thing about this is it can charge turrets and charge aid communicators and some others in the sentry terminal. Only thing you need to do is tap the generator with an electric node. Wherever the electric node went, I know I spawned it. Why can't I find it? Oh, it's right here. Yeah. Basically, tap the generator with the electric node, and once that has a wire connecting to it, you can spawn a turret. And I think if you tap it with a turret with, I think there has to be a battery connected to the turret. So let me connect a battery to it. Electricity. Now, yeah, there you go. So basically, your turrets have infinite power, or until the diesel runs out. Now, the wires can stretch pretty far until, like, the wires start to tense up like that. Because actually, this is surprising and really helpful about Gmod, is that Gmod wires, they do tense up. But the thing is that the electric node can go pretty far from the generator itself, so you can increase the distance with the electric with your turret, and if you stretch it out too far, it will disconnect the circuit or disconnect the wire, and you will run out of power from your turret. Same thing with aid communicators. I haven't really figured out what the hell they do. Only thing I know that they do is just make random noises. Just like
Sector. One, duty vacated.
Yeah. If you can't if you
extractor is live.
And it says it gives you like these orders from different stations. It's like unit 101 connected to station 41. This unit is authorized to transmit orders. So I have no idea what orders it will transmit. So that's something to look into. Now, you have multiple different fuels. You got your diesel, your gasoline, you have your kerosene canisters, which I don't know, I haven't really found a use for them yet. natural gas and propane. Now, all these are useful. If you click E on kerosene, it will light on fire. No, you cannot burn yourself with it. I've tried. Really, I have. You can run into it and try to burn yourself, but it won't hurt you. I think this is natural gas. I haven't really found a use for it at all, to be honest. I know one thing, though, that if you shoot it enough, it will explode or it will start flying. Flying. Now, propane doesn't do the same thing, I don't think. I don't think it will go off. I think propane will just explode. Yeah. Propane explodes if you shoot it. Diesel? Okay, kerosene, you can't get to explode. I'm sure. No matter how many bullets I've put into it, it can explode. Diesel? I don't think... Diesel cannot explode at all. Yeah. Diesel is basically one of the ones that cannot explode. Gasoline here can explode into a fire. And if you're near it, it will burn you for a long time. Even after you die and you spawn back, it will constantly just burn you. Let's see. Now, I haven't messed with the sentry terminals at all yet because I haven't figured out how to use them. I've tried using them. They just don't work. Oh, here we go. Okay, wireless connection established with Sentry 92. So this one must be Sentry 92. Error, no response from sentries. Is the sentry turned on? Okay, so activate. Alright, so this is sentry number 2. Or sentry. This is basically your sentry terminal. If you want to remote activate your sentry and basically take control instead of letting an AI take over. So if you want to like personally kill someone, this is the way to do it. The movement on the sentry is very slow, so there is a high zoom rate if you hold right click. But if you want to fastly like look around and scan the area, hold shift and A and D. Wait a minute. Are you? Why is my guy doing that? Anyway. Oh, and also has thermal vision. I forgot about that. So, this vision, I think, is for nighttime. This vision, mostly for daytime. Or maybe opposite, I don't know. And then you have your normal vision. I don't have any ammo in the turret, so I can't shoot it. There is no weapon switch. I forgot how to get out of it. Oh, okay. If you hit space, you can get out of it, and then the turret resets. Resets. The turret resets back at 00 on its coordinates, like default. So you got that. And that's how you activate, or that's how you work with the sentry terminals. And I think I've gone over everything, to be honest. Everything with armor, to generators with the explosives, and all the turrets on how to activate them and how to use them. Oh wait, no, I'm missing one thing. And this thing is probably one of the funniest but most deadly things here. So this thing requires, I want to say, 3 batteries. I'll exit. Nope. Okay. 2. It requires 2 batteries. Now, capacitor firing charge. This is damage capacity. Basically, you have 100%. When you have 100% power, the higher the damage, the more power you're going to use. So, let me just spawn some NPCs because I want to show you what this thing. You Sorry. Are supposed to be disabled. I thought I disabled. Oh yeah. I didn't disable. I reset it. That's why. Okay, now let me activate. NPCs, disable thing. Hey! Hey! Oh shit. Let me just move one over. Go away. Go to your friends. Go. Okay, well, let me spawn some more over there. This thing, it's detected on movement. Any, the slightest movement, it will zap basically anyone. Does he not know what to do? There we go! That is so funny! This is the best weapon in the, or best sentry in the fucking pack. I will admit, this is probably the best one out of them all. The thing is, though, oh, I don't know its range. Oh! That's the thing, I don't know its range. Oh, I think it ran out of power. Good. I think it died. Oh, good. 0 power. Woo! Yeah, this fucking Telsa. Oh, no, I don't want you. This fucking Telsa is amazing. Keep you there, and bye. It takes forever though to like set up. Thing is, the bodies twitch after they get shocked, which is another thing that makes it so brutal. Come on. Oh god. Get... Get zapped. The thing is, it only zaps one at a time. So, that's another thing that is, like, really bad about, or, like, terrible with, not terrible, what am I saying? It's a really decent. Go away. Alright. It's not terrible. It just, it's only a selective target system. So, like me. And it has a really large range, so if you have like two or three of these in a, like an open field, basically no one can get inside your base. Well, I'm gonna clean up everything. Jeez, I've made a mess around here. So, yeah, that's JI Defense Solutions, everyone. I hope you guys enjoyed. This is Mr. Korlak. And I'm actually trying to look for all my weapons. Yeah, so, basically, well, I don't know what to do now. Basically, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed. this is Mr. Korlak, and I will see you in the next video.